Hey guys, it's Kevin. So I started YouTube about 6 months ago. It's one of the best decisions I've ever made. It combines my passion for tech and my thirst for knowledge in one place. In today's video, I'm going to share some tips I used when I first started, as well as my process on how I create videos. So let's get started. Okay, my channel is very small, basically non-existent, so I won't go into too much detail since it doesn't matter, at the start. So there are three things that I keep in the back of my mind every time I want to create a video. One, make something that I'd want to watch. 2, do something I'm passionate about, and 3, have fun with it. Alright, let's start with number 1. If you're like me, then you probably ask yourself, what are people going to think? Or what if the video has already been uploaded? And the answer is, who cares? If you like listening to pop music and someone judges you for that, who cares? Or if you create a video that someone else already created, who cares? You can't make everyone like you, and that's completely okay. Every video I uploaded so far is something that I'd want to watch myself. I do cringe at my early videos, but that's normal. Just focus on yourself. It's your channel, not theirs. Moving on to number 2. Don't upload videos just for the sake of uploading videos. You're not going to enjoy it if you're forcing yourself. If you like skincare, then make videos about skincare. If you like cooking, then upload videos on cooking. For me, I love tech, so I focus on tech-related things like setups, unboxings, reviews, and more. Once you find what you're passionate about, you want to create more videos and upload them consistently. And finally, number 3. Don't focus on the numbers. In the beginning, no one will know who you are, so you have no views, no likes, and no subscribers. It's sad, but as long as you had fun creating that video, it won't matter. And when that one person does one or even all three of those, it's really exciting. Some of my videos have thousands of views, and some have not that many, but I still had fun with all of them. I learned new things with each video and made some mistakes along the way. But I don't get discouraged because I enjoy my entire process of creating a video. So after I engrave those 3 tips in my head, I start planning content. And I turn to YouTube for topics. I like tech, so I search for tech videos. And if the results are too broad, then I narrow it down to something like iPhones. Once I find a topic I like, I add it to a spreadsheet. And most of the time, one idea can lead to another. I can create a review of a phone, then I can have a video about its software, or I can have a comparison video between another phone. This spreadsheet helps me keep track of completed and upcoming ideas, the day it should go live, and the start and finish date. Okay, once I find a good topic, I'll start brainstorming and researching. I use pages for writing down ideas. If I think of a good idea while I'm watching a video, or playing video games, or in the bathroom, I write it down ASAP. You don't need to be glued to your desk to come up with stuff. After I have a good list, I begin scripting. It's not my favorite part because it takes so long to do, but the satisfaction I get when it's completed is worth it. Scripts also help me determine how long a video will be. For me, 2 pages is equivalent to a 5-minute video. Once the script is proofread, I can start recording my voiceover. Alright, unfortunately, I don't live alone, which is why I don't have any A-roll shots of me talking straight into the camera. Plus, it's rude to kick everyone out when I want to record something. I plan to record voiceovers around their time, so if they're gone for an hour or two, then it's a good time for me. I use this Blue Yeti mic for my voiceovers, and it's great. When I first started, I used this lav mic. Gear does not matter, at least in the beginning. The Blue Yeti is attached to this boom arm and shock mount, and I added this pop filter. I use Logic Pro or Audacity to record audio, and I monitor it in real time using AirPods Max, and I just read the script. After it's done and exported, I start recording clips. So I don't use those fancy cameras, I just use the one that's always with me, my phone. It's small, easy to use, and it records great videos. All the videos I uploaded on this channel were shot on a smartphone. I use the default camera settings on 4K 30fps with the occasional auto exposure and autofocus locking. Then I go by the script to see what clips I need. For my panning shots, I either use a tripod or this DJI OM5. I move the phone slowly in order to get that nice shot. For my overhead shots, I use this magic arm and attach it to a tripod. I also have some posters if I want to add some color. It's not the nicest setup, but it gets the job done. I try to record about 15 seconds for each clip. That way, I have some headroom when I'm editing. Once I have the necessary clips, I airdrop them to my Mac or use Google Photos if I use Android. Now for my favorite part, video editing. I love video editing, and I can spend days fine-tuning it to perfection, but I don't because if I keep making changes, then I'll never upload the video. So I use Final Cut Pro. It's pricey, but you can use iMovie to edit videos too. I create a new event, name it, and use the default settings in 4K. Then I import the voiceover, clips, music, and start aligning everything. I don't add too many effects or transitions, but it's a 2-to-1 aspect ratio crop, color grading, noise removal, and channel EQ. I play the final result in full screen to make sure it's something I'm proud of. Then it's uploaded to YouTube. And that's how I create videos. If you're thinking about starting YouTube, then I highly recommend you do, and I hope you find this video helpful. I'll link my gear and apps in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video, then please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!